What's up, back viewers? Today we're going to talk about this 40 inch Masterbuilt digital charcoal smoker. Yes, that's a mouthful. It kind of reminds you of the Masterbuilt 560 cousin back here, but in my opinion a little more flimsy and a little cheaper. I don't know if I love it. I haven't fired it up yet, saving that for this video, but there were just a few pain points that really got on my nerves when it came to this, but also a lot of potential. I'm just showing y'all the surface. You know, these scratches weren't there when I assembled it. I mean, they were here when I started to assemble. I'm gonna show y'all some pain points that I had. Kind of take a look here. This tacky welding, shame on you, Masterbuilt. You could have did better. You know, it's $349 suggested retail. Just go ahead and bump it up to $375 and use some thicker metal. With that said, it seamlessly pairs with the app, just like the 560. These stainless steel grates are more awesome than any of the other, you know, entry-level stainless steel grates that I've seen. It wasn't very hard to put together. Thought that I just kind of manhandled it and broke that off, but I saw a couple of people who had similar issues. Theirs actually arrived broken off, so you know it's not just a me thing. It's a Masterbuilt thing. But needless to say, we're gonna work through this. It's a pretty clever little cooker. Comes with a water pan rack. Smoker partition. Put that partition there. Hang on, guys. Move this out of the way. Use that partition when you want to go up to 275 and with your smoking temperature. If you're going to stay around 225, then you take it out, put it in just like that. If you put it in like this, you know, if you put in the partition, it won't really go past 275, they say. If you want to go above 275, like 300, then, you know, you take it out completely. Now, one of the things I didn't particularly care about when I got it open and, you know, read the instructions and everything was the fact that once you reach a temperature, say I start smoking at 225 and I decide I want to go to 275, but my meat starts cooking a little too fast, so I want to scale it back down. You can't. It's not built to function that way. But that's just one little small thing that I didn't really like after I got it. That is the stoker, where they try to do this without. That's where the fan blows up. A little bit of noise, y'all. Come here. Here's the charcoal. Here's a basket, ash pan. Uh-oh. Well, you get the point. Put that in there. Do a snake method if you're doing, you know, lower temperatures. Put your starter cubes right there. Start the fire. Really clean inside here, guys. Really nice. So, again, it's not the worst product in the world. It's entry level, so you can't really expect a whole lot, but this kind of reminds me of Dyno Glow, you know, the strength of the metal, and I prefer a little bit more coming from Masterbuilt. That's just my personal opinion, but we're going to see how it cooks. You know, how it cooks is what counts. This heat deflector comes out, so you can, you know, clean it really easily. I'm sorry about the camera, guys. I'm looking at the cooker and not the camera, so I'm not really sure where my angles are right now, but like I said, I put it together, started right up for me. Wish that Masterbuilt had given us a little gasket around the cook chamber. They did give us a little gasket around the firebox, which is, you know, pretty cool. Thank you. But I'm about to put this back in and start it up for you guys. Oh, one other difference with this is the cord. Cord's different sticker this time around. I think Masterbuilt probably had people complaining. Never had any problems with the 560. You see it cutting on. Hear it cutting on. Never had a problem with the 560's cord thickness, so I'm not going to start complaining about it now. But let's get this thing lit. It's supposed to be able to handle. It's supposed to last about 13 hours on a single basket. I don't know about that claim. It comes with four racks as well. So we're going to put all this stuff to the test. But to break it in, you have to smoke it at 225 for 2 hours and then 400 for an hour. Oh, and another thing, they recommend burning out after you're done cooking, period. The instructions said to let the rest of the charcoal burn out. I'm not sure if I love that or not, but we're going to throw some Kingsford in here. I got to use up this Kingsford charcoal. We're going to load this up and fire them up to see how it goes. All right, I'm going to show you all that, and then I'm going to peace out so we can kind of keep this video short. All right, y'all. We got some not so happy news out here. This one didn't make the cut. It's not going to make the cut. It don't got to go home, but it got to get up out of here. It's leaving the backyard. And it started out with the hinges. The hinges got on my nerves, and, you know, the not so good. I would say, I don't know. The cheap, we'll just call it like it is. The cheap material. I mean, you get what you pay for. The thing's what? Retails for, about 300, something, you know, whatever. But, you know, I just felt like there's some things. Concept-wise, it was okay. I didn't like that. You know, I didn't recommend to cut off the fire and save some of the charcoal. I want you to burn out the rest of the charcoal. But my biggest issue right here was the controller. During the warm-up process, this was clearly getting hot. You can see, you know, you could see the glass. It got frosty and all of this stuff. It was hot enough to warp the fire basket. But the temperature, it would not read beyond like 90-something degrees. And then I kept getting the E004 error. So I would have to turn it off, turn it back on, and that would clear the air. But the temperature still wouldn't show as climbing inside of the pit. So when I plugged it back in, only then would it briefly display the actual internal temperature, and it was reading well over 300 when I actually had it set at 225. So the motherboard or something on here is messed up. Needless to say, it can't hang out here. Got way too many cookers to take on any projects. Got to be game ready. So like the concept, you know, it's pretty cool design. Love the cabinets. I'm going with cabinets. I might still put this one in my flex video before it ships out. Do a flex video of all the cookers. I don't know. We'll see. Again, I like the concept, but Masterbuilt should have did a little better with this. I'm not the only one experiencing this, and that's why I'm saying that. So if you're in the market for it, just kind of keep that stuff in mind. Don't get it and need it that same day or same weekend. Give yourself a little time to make sure that everything is worked out the way that it should. I mean, you know, you can get some really good space in here if it's running right and it's doing what it's supposed to do. I imagine that, you know, it can really do some good things. But me personally, I'm not going to, you know, order parts and have them ship things and blah, 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 blah. I'm just getting rid of it. I'm going to be downsizing some stuff anyway. So it's first go. All right, y'all. Thanks for hanging out. Hope it helps somebody. I'll see you guys next time.